Well, according to an investigation by the Associated Press, Google is tracking where you are all the time, even after you wish it wouldn't.
So how do they do it? How are they getting away with it? And should we be worried?
There's nowhere to run and nowhere to hide.
I will look for you. I will find you.
Unless you throw your smartphone away, Google can track you even if you tell it not to.
It's a very dangerous piece of information. It can identify you, it can pinpoint where you live, where you work, where you shop, and other places where you maybe don't want to share where you've been.
You may think turning location services off will do the trick. Nope. Whether you like it or not, Google takes a location timestamp when you use apps like Maps and weather updates. Even if you simply Google something, they've got eyes on you. The tech giant also stores the information which it can use to target ads.
Our concern is it's not explained very clearly. It's not explained in an upfront way that people can find easily, and their location is being tracked in the background.
There is a way to stop it.
Whoa!
No, not with an invisible cloak.
My body's gone!
But a few other options.
It is so complicated to get all the tips. We're joined by tech expert Chris Riddell in Melbourne. Morning to you.
Morning.
Firstly, how are they getting away with this tracking?
Look, Google, you've got to remember one thing that's fundamental. Google is all about data. That's how they make their money. And if you're buying an Android device, then the fundamental issue that you're always going to be facing and you're always going to be chasing is that Google want to be able to get data out of your device on your behavior and what you're doing, because they need to be able to provide that to advertising companies. And that's the fundamental bottom line of this.
Okay, so that's how they make money, and a VPN won't fix this privacy issue. So what do people do if you don't want Google to follow you? Does it matter if Google is following you?
Look, I think that the problem that we've got here is you look at the situations that have been unravelling over the last 12 months or so with Facebook and Cambridge Analytica and how these big Silicon Valley companies are using our data. That's the issue here, and this is not going to go away anytime in the next 12 months. We're going to see more and more of this. Whether you're comfortable with that or not is a completely different thing. I mean, if we look at alternative manufacturers such as Apple with iPhone, they make money out of the device, so that's how they make their money trail. If you look at businesses like Google and the big data organizations like Facebook, they need your data to be able to make money because you're not paying for that service. So if you don't want them to track you and you don't want them to know what you're doing, then ultimately the bottom line is you shouldn't be using these services and you need to be looking at something else.
Oh, okay.
So don't use Google.
Yeah. All right, let's walk people through how to stop Google snooping. If you've got an Android phone, what do you do?
Look, if you've got an Android phone, you've got your Google settings that you go through in there. There's the menu function that you can go through and turn off web and app activity. That will help you to get some degree of privacy. As you already said, the VPN software often comes up. These VPN platforms that you can download apps, they don't work with this because a VPN is just designed to hide your web browsing activity with businesses such as ISPs and Telstra.
What about iPhone users? What do they do?
iPhone, go into settings, go through to your menu there, check what privacy settings you've got with Google apps and check the app access that they've got and be able to disable those Google permissions as well.
Okay, and PC users?
If you're still using a PC, I'm not quite sure who this would be in the world anymore, but go into your managed Google account, your personal info, your privacy, and then disable that through there in My Activity.
Yeah, that'd still be a lot. No, not you, Chris. Thank you.
We are not as trendy as you, Chris. Some of us still like an old-fashioned computer.
Thank you, Chris.